Marco.
Polo.
Marco.
Polo.
Marco. Oh, forget it. I can't find Marco Polo anywhere.
Well, that's because the BBC destroyed it like 50 years ago.
Oh, what? What was the point of the opening joke then?
I don't know. It was that or something about exploding bamboo.
Good point. Let's just get on with the video then. Wait, who am I talking to? Bum Marco Polo is the fourth Doctor Who serial and chronologically the first lost Doctor Who story. It's common knowledge for fans, but for anyone watching who doesn't already know, I'll quickly fill you in. It was common practice in the early days of television, at least with the BBC, to simply destroy or wipe over the master tapes for their existing properties. Because aside from the very rare rerun, there was no real home market at the time. Like, DVDs, VHS, they weren't a thing. Well, technically videotapes were a thing, but they weren't commonplace in the average household yet. I even remember watching some special features on a Doctor Who DVD years ago, where some guy shared a story about how he was present for the BBC destroying a lot of their tapes, and he just happened to pick up the Daleks and was like, can I keep this? And like he says, without that fortunate moment, the first ever Dalek story would be lost to time. Since the show's resurgence in 2005, numerous efforts have been made to recover or recreate many of the classic lost episodes. Over the years, classic episodes have shown up in basements, VHS recordings, and honestly, it's more fun to just research it yourself if that sort of thing interests you. There have also been numerous animated recreations, though I'll save my thoughts and opinions on those until I eventually get to one. In this case, for one reason or another, Marco Polo received no such animated reconstruction. I'll spare you the boring politics of it all, but basically, it would be a huge financial undertaking, so instead we get the Faceless Ones, the Macroterra, a second needless reconstruction of the Web of Fear on Steelbook Blu-ray for $49.99. Sorry. I am not a fan of the lazy reconstructions, but again, we shall cross that bridge when we come to it. Sorry for spending so much time on the minutiae of Lost Doctor Who episodes, but I don't want to have to go into detail every time I review one of these, so I'd rather just present all the information here so that people viewing these reviews in order will have all the info they need. Unless you're not watching these in order, or you're already new, in which case, sorry. Appreciate you sticking around though. So, having said all this, I watched what is known as the Loose Cannon reconstruction on YouTube. Now, I ended up having to delete like 2 pages worth of script notes just on Loose Cannon alone, but essentially, they are a group of dedicated Doctor Who fans who from 1997 all the way up to 2015 would recreate, reconstruct as many classic Doctor Who episodes as possible by any and all means. They are entirely separate from the BBC, and honestly, I was just blown away while researching them. Seriously, if you care at all about lost episodes, this team is a lifesaver, truly dedicated Doctor Who fans. So this is a full-colour reconstruction made using archival footage, screen stills, and off-air audio, as well as the actor for Marco Polo reprising his role to add a bit of extra context in the beginning via narration. Honestly, I have more to say on the amazing work done on the reconstruction than the episodes themselves. Not because they're bad. Oh no, not at all. I actually really enjoyed watching this 7-part story unfold. I can't really separate my thoughts about the episodes from the recon I watched because aside from the full original audio being present, I'd say it would be an entirely different experience watching a janky animated remake or the original unedited version that aired on television. So, once again, the story picks up right where the last one left off. At the end of Edge of Destruction, although the giant footprint in the snow never plays into anything in the story, like I assumed it would be a Yeti or an abominable snowman, but nope, never comes back again in the episode at all.
Oh wow, a giant footprint! Hey look, Mongols!
The Doctor and company soon find themselves in the care of one Marco Polo, a real-life historical figure who I knew absolutely nothing about before watching this. The overarching plot revolves around the group trying to fix and then reclaim the TARDIS from Polo while Starscream, Snively, Barbosa, Loki, the Warlord T'Gana trying to backstab Marco Polo and, you know, follow that well-worn cliché. What stood out to me was the impeccable writing and character interactions, and it was really cool getting to see other cultures. Of course, elephant in the room, it's impossible to tell while watching a still image reconstruction, but I'm sure that the authenticity would not meet today's standards. While there's some pretty authentic looking extras, pretty much all the main actors are English instead of their accurate ethnicity. At least 99% of them aren't doing like offensive stereotype voices. That 1% though, oof.
And now, if you step this way, I'll escort you to your apartment. Yeah.
I knew I had seen her before, my lord. Silly child, let herself be robbed.
What?
The colorized still images helped to immerse me in the story without being taken out by possible offensive stereotypes. Man, I am not looking forward to the talons of Wing Chang. We get some much needed background info on our characters, like apparently Susan is only 16. The Doctor, while being both loopy, is also a little bit psychotic.
Grandfather!
It's goodbye, see, he says.
Why are you laughing? He means it. Doctor, he's serious.
I know he is, yes.
What are you going to do?
Oh, I haven't the faintest idea.
Don't worry, my child. I think by the time I finish with that gentleman, he'll only be too glad to let us go.
The only thing I find it hard to buy is that Ian and Barbara have seemingly forgotten the reality of their situation and apparently are just fine with being, you know, essentially kidnapped by the Doctor. Like, did y'all really forget that you're being held against your will, forced to face Daleks, Mongols, and melted clocks? Let's see what else. Oh yeah, the sandstorm from episode 2 is genuinely terrifying. Like, having just the crusty audio without any moving pictures to accompany it just forces your imagination to just conjure up all sorts of frightful visuals. The effect would have almost certainly been lost watching the original version that aired, because apparently the special effects didn't look that great when translated to television. Overall, I really liked this one as a fun audio adventure with some decent visuals to help guide us through the story. The music was quite nice too. Again, I have no idea how authentic it is, but it gave me major Kung Fu Panda vibes, so, you know, I'm always a sucker for that. Mad props to the incredible work done by the Loose Cannon Productions team. It really is a shame that Marco Polo was lost, because the set design and the props look incredible! I can't tell if they reused the same set over and over again with different props, or if it was just the photo that they chose to use several times throughout the reconstruction. How many times have I said reconstruction in this video? Negatives. Not heaps. I mean, there's always a bit of cringe that comes with watching old television shows, particularly in Doctor Who's case, every time somebody screams really dramatically, only for it to turn out to be a painting, or a rock, or a clock. Oh, there's my favourite nitpick, the overused, overly loud sound effect that plays over and over again. In this case, it's a water dripping sound, which sounds identical whether they're inside the TARDIS or inside a cave. I mean, come on, surely you can relate to having a tap constantly dripping in the background driving you crazy, right? It's not just me. Actually, speaking of that, how does the TARDIS not have air conditioning? Like, I know I love to joke about the OG TARDIS being really crappy, but if you're getting enough condensation on the walls of the console room to fill up a water canteen, then the Doctor really needs to rethink his insulation options, right? Get a friggin' dehumidifier or something. Crack open a window.
Crack open the window of the TARDIS.
And there you have it. A longer than necessary review of a Doctor Who story where I spend more time talking about external factors than the episodes themselves. I'd appreciate it if you bear with me while I figure out how I want these reviews to go. At least I won't be repeating the whole spiel about the BBC destroying their master tapes again. Marco Polo is a fun story. While dragging at times due to it being a 7-parter, with a seriously abrupt ending, at least I was kept entertained and invested with cool locations and characters I genuinely liked. While quite educational, I can't say I know any more or less about the Mongolians or Marco Polo himself after watching it. Not that it's the fault of the episodes, no, it's probably just my brain not retaining the information. Two big questions I have after watching though. Number one, do people just not know about condensation back in the 1200s? It's a bit of a weird plot point to focus on. And two, is it just me or do these amazing actors resemble Carl Urban and David Hasselhoff? No, just me? Okay, I'll shut up and go now. Oh, before I sign off though, I should quickly mention that the Edge of Destruction DVD that comes with the beginning box set also contains a highly abridged version of Marco Polo. It's black and white, it's half an hour long, and honestly, I just don't recommend watching it as a first viewing because you just miss out on way too many important plot details. Yet they still kept the TARDIS condensation bit in there. Weird decision. It might be alright for a short revisit or a quick story recap, but shortening a 2.5 hour epic down to half an hour means you're missing out on a lot, like entire characters are just forgotten about. They're just not in it. Thanks a million for watching. I'm really enjoying making these. Next up, we'll be taking a look at the Keys of Marinus. Marinus? Sorry if I butcher the pronunciations of a lot of episodes. I haven't seen them yet, but I'm looking forward to it. See you next time. Hopefully.